He said he asked you if you could wind up doing more good as a former president than as a president. And you said, only if I live a long time.
Yeah, that's true.
How do you rate, compare the powers of being a president and the
president? Well, when you're president, you can follow a much broader stretch that, for example, the climate change should be changed.
again, to be too morbid, but this is what he said. He asked you if you could wind up doing more good as a former president than as a president. And you said, only if I live a long time.
Yeah, that's true.
How do you rate, compare the powers of being in office as president and what you can do out there as a senator?
Well, when you're president, you can... can do as a former president is you don't have a problem with the election that you are not to promote your country. So I'm saying, look, you're an American president, and you're not going to be able to do it. And you're going to be able to do it. And you're going to be able to do it. And you're going to be able to do it. And you're going to be able to do it.
think Mr. Clinton agreed to his first one-on-one interview ever on Fox News Sunday. The barriers were simple. 15 minutes for our sit-down split evenly between the global initiative and anything else he wanted to ask. But as you'll see now in the full, unedited interview, that's not how it turned out. On the New Year. More than $7 billion is spent to tackle some of the worst problems in developing countries, such as poverty, disease, and climate change. As part of the conference, Mr. Clinton agreed to his first one-on-one interview ever on Fox News Sunday. The ground rules were simple. 15 minutes for our sit-down split evenly between the global initiative and anything else we wanted to ask. But as you'll see now in the full, unedited interview, that's not how it turned out. Mr. President, welcome to Fox News Sunday. In a recent issue of the New Yorker, you say, quote, I'm 60 years old and I've damn near died, and I'm worried about how many lives I can save before I do die. Is that what drives you in your efforts to help in these developing countries?
Yes, but I don't mean that's kind of sort of morbid when you say it like that. But the way I said it, this is what I love to do. It is what I think I should do. That is, I've had a wonderful life. I got to be president. I got to live the rest of my dreams. My dad's to do it. We got help from